Hello everybody, welcome to this next video. In this video, here we have a series of questions which were there in the previous year's UGC NET exam. So this particular problem was there in June 2015. It was of 4.75 marks. So let us look at the statement. So the statement says consider non-zero vector spaces v1, v2, v3, v4. So you have to see these are the three vector spaces which are non-zero, so they are not trivial. Fine. Okay, and you have linear transformations. You have three linear transformations. Phi1 is from V1 to V2, Phi2 is from V2 to V3, and Phi3 is from V3 to V4. And you are given some information about the kernel and range of these maps. So you are given that kernel of Phi1 is a zero space, range of Phi2 is kernel of range of Phi1 is kernel of Phi2, range of Phi2 is kernel of Phi3, and range of Phi3 is whole of V4. So you have to see which of the following four relations which are given to you are true, right? Okay, fine. So here you see here this relation on the left hand side, I from 1 to 4 dimension of VI with alternating signs, and similarly I from 1 to 4 dimension of VI with alternating sign, and here also dimension dimension of VI, I from 1 to 4, right? So all these expressions are same. So we'll just first look at this expression, and this expression is different because here I start from 2. So first let us look at this expression. So solution is, if you look at this expression, I from 1 to 4 minus 1 raised to power I dimension of VI. So this is actually dimension of when I is 1, so minus sign V1 plus dimension of V2 minus dimension of V3 plus dimension of V4. So this is what the expression is. So let us see what is given to us. We are given Phi1 is from V1 to V2, and it is given to you that kernel of Phi1 is 0. Kernel of Phi1 is 0. It means that nullity of Phi1 is 0. Nullity of Phi1 is 0. And rank of Phi1 is equal to dimension of V1. This is from rank nullity theorem. Right? How? We have rank nullity theorem says that rank of Phi1 plus nullity of Phi1 is equal to dimension of the domain space, that is V1. Right? Here nullity is 0, that is why rank of Phi1 is dimension of V1. So this is the information we have about Phi1. Now let us look at Phi2 is from V2 to V3. It is given that range of Phi1 is kernel of Phi2. So therefore we are given that rank of Phi1 is same as nullity of Phi2. Fine. Okay. Let us look at next thing. Phi3 is from V3 to V4, and it is given to you that range of Phi2 is same as kernel of Phi3. It means that it is given to you that rank of Phi2 is same as nullity of Phi3, and further you are given that range of Phi3 is V4. It means that rank of Phi3 is dimension of V4. We don't know the dimension of V4 as of now. We don't need it actually. Okay, fine. Now let us look at this. Now you have dimension. You will start with say dimension of V1. Dimension of V1, I will start with this. This is nullity of Phi1 plus rank of Phi1. Right? Nullity of Phi1 plus rank of Phi1. Now this is 0. Therefore, this is rank of Phi1. Right? So rank of Phi1 from here is nullity of Phi2. So this is nullity of Phi2. Now what is nullity of Phi2? Nullity of Phi2 is, this by the theorem, this is dimension of V2 minus, right, this is because your Phi2 is a map from V2 to V3. So rank of Phi2 plus nullity of Phi2 is dimension of V2. Therefore, nullity of Phi2 will be dimension of V2 minus rank of Phi2. Now use this relation. Rank of Phi2 is nullity of Phi3. So this is dimension of V2 minus, this is nullity of Phi3. Now what is nullity of Phi3? Use the same thing. Pi3 is a map from V3 to V4, right? So this will be dimension of V3 minus rank of Pi3. Right. Now use this relation. Rank of Pi3 is same as dimension of V4. So you get dimension of V1 is equal to dimension of V2 here. V2 minus dimension of V3 plus rank of Pi3, which is same as dimension of V4. Right. So from here you get minus dimension of V1 plus dimension of V2 minus dimension of V3 plus dimension of V4 is 0, which is your first relation, first expression. So first expression is correct. So this option is correct option. Now if you are saying that this is a correct option, then obviously this has to be wrong option, because this expression is same. If you are proving that some expression is 0, that expression cannot be less than 0 and that cannot be not equal to 0. So these two options are gone. So you are left with just this option. So let us look at the second option, because you can have more than one correct option also. So let us look at the second option. B option is your I from 2 to 4 minus 1 raised to power I dimension of VI is greater than 0 or not. So this is actually dimension of V2 minus dimension of V3 plus dimension of V4. This is what we have to look for. This is equal to, now you see what is dimension of V2. Dimension of V2 is rank of Pi2 plus nullity of Pi2. Nullity of Pi2, right? And this is further you can write it as, keep it as such, dimension of V3 plus dimension of V4. Now let us see what we need know about nullity of Pi2 or rank of Pi2. Let us go at our options. You have nullity of Pi2 is same as rank of Pi1, right? And anything else, the information you have, you have rank of Pi2 is same as nullity of Pi3, right? So you can use it here. So this is nullity of Pi2. You can write in place of rank of Pi2, this is same as nullity of Pi3. In place of this I am writing here. Rank of Pi2 is same as nullity of Pi3. This is what I am writing here. Minus, here I am using rank nullity theorem. So this will be nullity of Pi3 plus rank of Pi3. Fine. And I am keeping dimension of V4 as such. Now you see, this and this will cancel. So you will be left with nullity of Pi2 minus rank of Pi3. Nullity of Pi2 minus rank of Pi3 plus dimension of V4. Right. Now let us see, do we have anything other information? Let us go to our relations. You have rank of Pi3 is as same as dimension of V4. So rank of Pi3 is same as dimension of V4. So you are left with nullity of Pi2. Now let us see what is nullity of Pi2. Let us go back to your relations again. So you have nullity of Pi2 is same as rank of Pi1. So this is same as rank of Pi1. And rank of Pi1 is same as dimension of V1. So you get that the expression, which is I from 2 to 4 minus 1 raised to power I dimension of VI is equal to dimension of V1, which is greater than 0, because V1 is a non-zero space. It is given in the question. So this expression is also correct. So this is also correct option. So your answers for this particular problem are A and B, right? They are the correct options. So you see how this question is about beautifully using your rank nullity theorem, right? Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to this channel and share this video with your friends.